Arduino comes with a 80 mega 8-bit processor or a CPU. So we can use the computing power of this CPU to perform basic mathematical operations like subtraction, division, multiplication, and addition. So here I write a code which uses the processing power of this CPU and do the basic mathematical operations. Let us now first write the code and then go through the code, and then we'll perform the basic mathematical operations using the processing power of the chip. After writing the code, connect the Arduino to the computer so that we can use it as the processor or the CPU. So let us now go through each line of this code. So as you can see, I have declared two variables of data type float and a character named operate that will be the mathematical symbols as characters. Again, another variable result of data type float. So we are considering float because we can perform the operations on decimals, and if our operation returns decimal, then it will be shown as decimal and not rounded to the nearest integer. That's the difference between float and int, of course. Then void setter. Yeah. Here we are setting the baud at 9600 because this is the default baud. Let me show you. When we open the serial monitor, we can see that the default baud is at 9600. So we can also change the baud at, suppose, say 19200. Then let us upload this code. Now if we change the baud here, we need to change it also in the serial monitor, or it will display something like this. So what we need to do, that we also need to change it to 19200 baud. So let us do that. And now we can see that the text appears again. So yeah, we can do any mathematical operation. I'll come back to that later. Then we started a loop. If we don't use the loop, then we can perform only a single operation and then it will come out. So using this loop, we are using it again and again. I mean, we can perform the operations again and again. So yeah. Now we are using parse float instead of read, because if we use read, then only the first digit of a number will be considered. For example, if we enter 71, then only the first digit, that is 7, will be considered. So if we use parse float, then the whole digit, whole number 71 will be considered. And operate is read because it is only a single character. Then again, int2 is that. And then println, we are using println because after printing this line, it will automatically go to the next line, and we do not need to use another next line character. That's the way, that's the use of println. Then again, here we have declared a user defined function solve, and this is the declaration. This is the operation that this function will carry out. It is just a switch statement. So it is quite clear here when the operate, that is the operator inputted by the user, is negative, minus subtraction will be carried on, and in case of addition will be carried on in between the numbers n1 and n2. Same for multiplication and division. That's it. And this is the default statement, invalid. If you type some full stop dot in place of that, this characters, then nothing will happen and the invalid statement will be printed. That's about the code. Now this is already uploaded, so let us now open the serial monitor and perform operation. So enter a basic mathematical operation. Say we want to divide 56 by, say, 9.87. We can do this. Just enter it and press enter, and the answer is 5.67. Enter next operation. Here it is. Enter next operation. Here we can see the use of loop. It is again executed. The same function is again executed, and we can perform the next mathematical operation. Say 71 multiplied by 76.09845, something like this. Ok can perform this, press enter, and again the answer is 5402.99. That's it. Now to open the serial monitor, we need to go to tools, and under tools we'll get the serial monitor, or simply we can press Ctrl plus Shift plus M. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up, and if you don't, thumbs down is always there. And any comments or suggestions, please drop them in the comment box below. I will love to hear it from you. Thank you, and see you in the next video.